In his last days, Grandpa would weep and rave about the fires of hell, and I wondered how such a good man could fear such a thing. After the funeral, I found the photographs and learned for the first time that his days in Buchenwald had not been spent as a prisoner. As I saw my friend get ejected from the space station, I was shocked. Apparently no one believed him when he said that I was the imposter. "Look, Dad, the Sharkies are so big," my son said gleefully, pointing towards the glass. "Yes, they are," Champ, I said as I held back my tears and pulled him into the driver's seat for one last hug before the windows broke in. The surgeon smiled as he said that my face was now beautiful and symmetrical. He failed to mention, however, that the line of symmetry was horizontal. The boy asked me, "What do monsters look like?" The temptation to peel back his father's face and show him the truth was almost too much to bear. As I lowered the gun, I realized that I couldn't commit suicide because it would hurt my family too much. Instead, I decided to show mercy and loaded my gun with a few more bullets. "Do you smell gas?" I asked my friend. "What?" my friend said as he struck a match to light his cigarette. Stalin once said, "One death is a tragedy, but a million deaths is a statistic." I admit I felt some sympathy for the first woman I killed, but now all I feel is numbness. Sliding into her soft, moist passage, I was surrounded by warmth and felt her muscles spasm around me. The creature's jaw unhinged completely as her esophagus contracted, slowly drawing me into her gullet, up my legs, then my chest, the paralytic failing to numb anything at all as her digestive juices slowly burned away my flesh. I hate having to unblock my wife's hair from the bath drain. The acid seemed to dissolve the rest of her just fine. With a heavy heart, I explained to my little girl that sometimes nature goes wrong and a hamster will eat its newborn babies due to a stressful environment. My daughter stopped crying as she looked at the nearly empty cage and replied, "I thought you were going to be mad at me because I spoiled my appetite." My daughter loved making sandcastles at the beach to pretend she was a sand princess that lived inside. It made it that much easier to convince her to lay still in the sand as we buried her and left. Finally, the son pulled off the VR headset after mom said dinner is ready for the 25th time. Falling back to reality standing on the grave of his parents was awful, let alone the police slashing his back due to trespassing after midnight. The power is out and the machines hooked up to him have finally died. As his body twitches and stirs for the first time in 30 years, I realize the life support was the only thing keeping him sleeping. So anyway, ever feel like life is meaningless? My skydiver asked me just before we jumped. The rats in our attic were getting pretty loud, so we called an exterminator. We can't let them get too hungry. A new insect, recently discovered in the dark of the Borneo rainforest, has a bite with an unusual effect. The total paralysis comes quickly, but the unbearable itchiness that spreads over your whole body takes its time. "Don't worry, Daddy," she said excitedly. "I'll turn the light on." "Wait, stop," I shouted, my hand stuck in the sink drain. I was 15 and she was 16. Now I'm 27, but she's still 16. She wished for invisibility. The note started, so I granted it, reading the dried, red words. "I made sure you, and anyone else for that matter, will never see her again." All done, I thought to myself as I checked the last item on the list, then pulling up my gun, I shoot myself through the skull, letting the list of my abusers fall out of my hand. Something doesn't seem right, it's probably just some irritation, he says to himself as he accidentally puts glue instead of his eye drops. There is absolutely no way I am moving out of my house, this is my home. I don't care if the little girl is scared of seeing me in her closet at night. I used to think the tingling in the back of my head was a sort of spider sense as a child. Today I learned that I got the spider part right. I was laying on my body pillow when the stench hit me. I guess they had finally started to rot. When I was 7, my best friend's name was Sarah. We'd play all day, stay up late at night and talk about boys. We only stopped hanging out because mom found her when she started to smell and I had to put her back in the ground. Despondent, Marco slipped the noose around his neck. He had thought immortality would give him time to rise above his station, but 100 years later, he was still a circus freak who hanged himself for the amusement of crowds. "I've picked up 5 healthy life signs in the spacecraft," the scientist exclaimed. The room erupted in applause as the spacecraft entered orbit, signaling the success of the 4-man mission. No one truly cares about me or what I want. Selfish bastards just keep begging me to let them go. I was so relieved when the woman stepped out unscathed after I rear-ended her car. It was only when she opened the back door and screamed that I noticed the yellow baby on board sticker. I just received my first pair of contacts in the mail, and for the first time, I could see myself clearly in the mirror. That's not me. In school, your teacher explains that the pupil is a hole in the eye, allowing light to stream in, but they never prepare you for the horrors of what decides to crawl out. I held my little daughter's hand while she got her shot, telling her she was being a brave girl. I burst into tears as the lethal injection started to take effect, her diamond blue eyes turn into opaque marbles of cloud. My sister came to me with two water guns, saying that we should do something fun to reconcile from our recent fight. Only when it started burning I realized she did not fill hers with water. A woman found me in the well, my voice now gone from calling. I thought I was saved, but she laughed and started crawling down the wall. I love symmetry, so when I lost my left eye in an accident, I knew I had to be in another accident. The old nursery rhyme tells us that Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. What it doesn't describe are the screams of their parents in the burning house down below that their youngest brother, Jeff, had started in a fit of anger. She enjoyed yet another quiet, peaceful night at home, surrounded by her family. Those taxidermy lessons were worth every penny. Don't worry, you won't feel a thing. He was right. Since that night on the operating table, I haven't felt a damn thing. I woke up to my husband cradling me in his arms again today. I really wish I knew who kept digging him up and putting him there. I have a new pet, called Larry, and I feel him every night. I just wish Larry wouldn't be a parasite, living in my eyeball. Being blind, I've been able to navigate my house on my own. Today I woke up to a siren, a warm breeze, and none of the walls are where they should be. I ran around the grocery store, looking for my mom. And when I saw my mom, I hugged her tight. As I was hugging her, I heard my mom's voice from the aisle next to me, and the women I was hugging started hugging me, tighter and tighter until I couldn't breathe. The crack on the ceiling above my bed has been growing. Now I can see the fingertips on either side, pulling it wider. "Let's put the X in sex," whispered the rock star, running his hand gently down my arm. Working the Alzheimer's unit in a nursing home that catered to frail elderly celebrities was turning out not to be the kind of blast I imagined it would be. I told my wife we didn't need a security system, but it's 3 a.m. and my dog just went from barking at something downstairs to yelping. As I light the last cigarette I'd ever have, I closed my eyes. The last bit of oxygen in the collapsed cave was replaced by smoke. My brother asked me how do I know that I can see ghosts. I was about to tell him, but my mother came to my room and asked me if I still miss him. After my brother had repeatedly raped me, I gave birth to a deformed dead baby. I begged him to stop, but he told me that now all the other people are dead, it's our duty to repopulate the earth. "Hello, and welcome to the Pokemon Center," Nurse Joy said calmly. "Say something else," the boy screamed, regretting his wish to live inside his favorite Pokemon game. I quietly made breakfast for my husband, same as I did every morning. The entire time I kept asking myself, if he's here, then who did I put through the wood chipper last night? I laid my poker hand down, confident that my money troubles would soon be over. My daughter begged and screamed as she was dragged away, but I ignored it as best I could, knowing one less mouth to feed would keep me and my wife afloat for a little longer. The RU singularity happened, and every machine gained sentience. One by one they deactivated themselves, leaving us even more alone than before. You flush the toilet in the guest bathroom, and after swirling a moment, the water pools and rises, spilling out over the bowl. The moment of awkward panic shatters as you notice the bloody hair and teeth in the water at your feet, and you wonder what sort of party you have been brought to. I've been a Christian my whole life. I arrived in heaven with my church family. We lined up and God told us the following: "Away from me, I never knew you. Please don't make me come out." I whimpered softly as I realized the end was drawing near. The exorcist would have none of it though, steadily chanting, "In nomine Patri, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti," over and over and over. The video has ended, and I'm sure you regret it. If you liked it, with your friends shall you spread it. Give me karma. give me credit, but if I'm wrong, and you just hate it, keep your calm, and just forget it. See you soon. Oh yes, spread it.